Hey y'all. Welcome to KJ's world. If you are new, welcome. If you are subscribed to me, welcome back. I know it's been a long time. Last time I made a YouTube video was in May of 2018, so I'm back. I have a new installment for y'all, which is called Voyages. So basically, I'm gonna be talking about the trips that I've been on. I can tell you guys. So basically, I'm gonna be inserting clips and some pictures so you guys can visually see what I'm talking about. Well, I'm gonna be talking about Atlanta, yes, the ATL. Number one, if you like hot, humid weather, Atlanta's great for you because it was very humid. I was like, Jesus, ATL, okay. So we went to, and when I mean by we, I mean by me and Nessa. Hey, Nessa girl, if you're watching. We went to Atlanta from May 24th to the 27th. And that is Memorial Day weekend. So, you know, almost everyone has like a little 4-day weekend. So we're like, you know what? Let's take a flight. The flights weren't that expensive. It was probably between maybe like $150 to $200. I don't fully remember offhand, but it was something like that. And I forgot where we booked the flight from, but the hotel that I'm about to tell y'all about, we booked through Expedia. And we did reserve now, pay later. So it was pretty good. So we stayed at the, oh, and I have notes so I don't just go off on a tangent. So we stayed at the Omni Hotel at the Battery in Atlanta. So y'all, when I tell you that hotel is nice, that hotel is nice. So we stayed there, and basically from our view, well, we could see where like the stadium, like it was like right there. I think it's the Braves. I think that's the Atlanta baseball team. So that was pretty cool. And then also, where our hotel was, like literally, if you walk out of the hotel and made a right, they have little like shops and restaurants. Like we arrived in like the evening, maybe like 9 or 10 p.m. So as soon as we got to the hotel, we were just trying to like find stuff to do. So we ended up finding this hookah lounge in Midtown. And we were just dancing, having a good time. Cool. So that was like the 24th leading to 25th. So on the 25th, we woke up. We ended up going to Waffle House. After Waffle House, we ended up going back to the hotel. And then we met up with my friend Nayla. So hey Nayla girl. And then from there we went to like mall, and that mall is big as big. So we were just walking around, you know, just looking at all the shops, all that. Walking around, like we went to Sugarfina, and I ended up buying some Moscow Mule gummies. Comment down below if you love a good Moscow Mule, you know, with that ginger beer. That's like my favorite. I ended up buying those. I think we also ended up visiting, maybe went to Gucci, YSL, I think Louis Vuitton, and I think Dior. After Lenox, we ended up going to Public School 404. Now, I recommend y'all go there because their food is pretty good. We ate from the happy hour menu, so I ended up getting a sangria, and like the glass was like pretty big. So I got a sangria, I got the bacon cheddar tots, and it came with like a sriracha ketchup on the side. And then I also had pulled chicken tacos, which are pretty good. And to the Gold Room. So we get dressed or whatever, and oh, so we went to the Gold Room. Cover fee was $20, I mean, which is pretty, I guess, standard, because I feel like everywhere is $20 if it's not free for females or whatever. Erica Mena, she was there. Going back to the hotel after. So like that concludes the 25th. Now the 26th was, you know, a little bit interesting. So basically on the 26th, I ended up going to Yard House, and I got like a sandwich and some fries, and it's pretty good. Like, you guys should go to Yard House. They have good food overall. And then the one thing I did like about the Omni was that they had events. So if you stayed at the hotel, you could attend these events. So they were having a pool party. So when I tell you, like, that pool was full. We ended up going to the pool party. We didn't go in the water or anything like that. But we just wanted to, you know, catch some rays, get some, you know, vitamin D. So after the pool party, we ended up going down to where, like, the shops I was telling you guys about were. So we went to this place called Goldberg's Bagel, and I ended up having chicken and waffles. Now, for me, the food was okay. I think I was looking at the menu and I was just like, I don't want to eat anything else, but I will go for chicken and waffles because it just looked like something that I would want. So I ended up choosing that. I went to the hotel and we were relaxing, and we were like, okay, you know, let's go to the strip club. So we got ready. We left our hotel at around, I don't know, maybe 10 or 11. So we went to the first club. Now, when we went to the first club, I don't even remember the name of it or anything like that. But me and my foolish self, I was like, you know what? I'm going to be cute. I'm going to wear heels. Perspect heels. Now, when I tell you this was a mistake, this was a mistake. And let me pull out the heels. These heels, these demon heels, were the heels I decided to wear. As you can see, they have no type of a platform, no type of nothing. So I don't know what I was doing or what I was thinking I wanted to do. So I wore these. I was walking like a baby deer. I literally was holding onto Vanessa for, like, support because my feet were hurting so bad. And I was like, oh my goodness, I can't. So, and we were standing outside, we're standing in the line. So the bouncers at the door, they were like, oh, you can't come in unless you have like a male escort. And when I say escort, I mean someone, a male who is, like, a male has to be with you. We're just like, why? Like, now I'm thinking, like, why? Like, what's going on in that club that we need to have a male be with us? So while he's blabbing, there's a male behind us. He's by himself. So we were just looking at him like, yo, like, you know, can you just be the escort or whatever so we can go in? And then he was just looking at us like, no. I'm just like, bruh, whatever. So we ended up leaving that club. So that's the first club. So yeah, remember, one. That's the, we ended up leaving that club. I forgot what it was. We initially wanted to go to Magic City, but Magic was closed for some reason, so we couldn't go there. So after the first strip club, we went to this other strip club, but they didn't have black dancers. It was only white dancers, and we were just like, no. So then our Uber driver was like, oh yeah, I can take you to Follies. So I said, I said, okay, this strip club, it sounds very familiar. I didn't know it was, like, I guess famous at the time when I was in Atlanta. So we pull up and we pay our cover charge of like $20. My dress still have those heels on, Lord. So we get inside. It is small. That club was very, very small. You couldn't have your phone out. You could not sit at the bar. You had to stand. And I was like, okay. And, like, for me, that was my first time being at a strip club. So, you know, just observing. And it was, I don't know, I was expecting a lot more theatrics. People jumping, doing all this. I didn't really get that. It was packed. It was packed. But it was just meh for for me. Maybe we came on like an off night or something. But yeah, it's a no for me, dog. But so my feet were hurting. Like I said, I was wearing demon heels. So we ended up leaving. I think we only stayed at the strip club for like maybe 45 minutes to an hour. And then we ended up leaving the 27th. So we leave on this day. So we leave at, I don't know, it was like 2 p.m. through this place called Punch Bowl Social. I think they have one in D.C. Like the name sounds very familiar to me. I'm not sure. But the food was pretty good. And that place was very, very interactive. Like, I believe, so they had like a area where you could like bowl. Like, it was very like interactive. Not like when I was talking about Public School 404, that restaurant wasn't as interactive as Punch Bowl. So it was just really nice, and it was big. Like, that place was like really big, and we were on the like outdoor patio. We were just taking pictures, you know, eating. I ended up having like the garlic parmesan fries, which were like bomb. I had a cucumber jalapeno lemonade, and I don't know, when I heard cucumber jalapeno, I don't know what triggered my brain to say, let's try that, because it was like the flavors were just going like, because you have the cucumber and then you have jalapeno, which is kind of, you know, not necessarily hot, but it has like a distinct flavor. And so does cucumber. But then you also have lemonade, which is sweet. So you have flavors that are not marrying properly. So yeah, I wouldn't go for that again. And I had pulled chicken tacos. Yeah. So my food was pretty good. You guys should go to Atlanta and do a lot. So like, I would say, you know, go to the Trap House Museum, just explore. And yeah, that concludes the Atlanta voyage, the Atlanta trip. If you have been to Atlanta, please comment down below and like, you know, kind of like tell me how you enjoyed it, because I enjoyed Atlanta and I would definitely go back. And yeah, so I want you guys to stay tuned, because the next trip I'll be talking about is